Well, my next guest, guest starred on in an off-Broadway review. New York Times compared her to a young Barbara Streisand. Now she plays Frankie Bunsen, who is the fast-talking DJ on the hit series China Beach. And there's just no one to compare her to. You'll see in this clip. Sandy?
Don't make me over. Now that you know how I adore you. Don't make me over. Now that I do anything for you. Don't make me over. Make me over, now that I do anything for you. Don't make me over, don't make me over. Now that you've got me at your command. Accept me for what I am. Accept me for the things that I do.
Incomparable Nancy Giles.
Nancy!
Arsenio!
Where did they get young Barbara Streisand from?
Well, it's really because the number that I did in the show, I was sitting in a chair, sort of wandering around the stage talking about being a secretary, and nobody noticed me, but I was having a lot of affairs on the sly. And she did a show where she did a number where she was sitting in a chair talking about how nobody noticed her. So, I think that's
okay. Yeah. Okay. How did you get China Beach?
I paid for it, pretty much. I wrote them a large check. And, uh-huh. Yes, no. I was doing a show in New York, the one that they Barbara Streisand me with, mm-hmm. and the writer's strike was going on, and somebody came from California to come and meet some actors, and I was one of the people that they met, and I got a chance to screen test for the show. And the funny thing was, they kept telling me, just be yourself, just be Nancy. And all I wanted to do was throw up the entire time that I was there. I was that sick. But thank God it worked out great, and I'm working on the show and I love doing it.
Yeah.
It's wonderful.
You're born New York, East Coast?
In Queens.
Queens?
Yeah. Queens, New York.
And you're living here now?
I'm living here. No, I'm commuting from Queens. And boy, are my arms tired. I'm sorry, yeah. That's so dumb.
No, but you actually have bought a place.
You know,
you've actually bought a place out here?
No, I'm renting a place. I haven't bought a place. No, I'm renting a great apartment in Beverly Hills.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Now, do you like Beverly Hills?
Yeah, I love it. It's great.
Because a lot of people from New York have a hard time adjusting to Beverly Hills.
Oh, no, well, you know, it's fun if you want to keep like a tally of how many Rolls Royce Corniches you see. It's my comedy partner, that's her dream car, Gloria Gifford. She like loves Rolls Royce Corniches. So that's fun. See how many of those you see, Jags and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And then how frightened you are of getting close to those cars. You just want to stay away. You know what I mean?
You said your partner.
Yes, comedy partner.
So
when I'm not doing China Beach, I'm working on a show with Gloria Gifford. You know her. She was in 48 Hours, and I know you know who she is. She was one of the, pardon the expression, hookers, but that's what she was.
In the movie, though?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And she's... Yes, in the movie. Yeah, in the movie, my God! No, she's a talented, beautiful actress.
Yes.
She was acting the part of a woman of ill repute. Okay, but...
Yeah.
So we do this act. We're doing it actually at the Gardenia, like next month, which is a club in Hollywood.
Sunset La Brea.
Yeah, Santa Monica La Brea.
Yeah, Santa Monica, right by that plant shop.
The plant shop, the Gardenia, right next to it.
Yeah.
And we're kind of like Martin and Lewis, and you've never seen an act like this before, certainly with two women and not two black women.
Mm-hmm.
She's like a romantic, and she sings these beautiful, luscious songs, and is also very, very funny. And I'm like the funny Jerry Lewis side, and I also sing songs and try to be romantic, but the strength of the show is that we're such opposites. You know what they say, opposites attract.
Yes.
It's a real powerhouse show.
Did you ever do stand-up alone?
I did. In fact, I know Michael Wolff from a club where we used to work in New York, and I sort of semi-did stand-up, but I can't really call myself a stand-up now when I've seen people who really do it, like you used to do it.
Not tonight.
No. Yes, was very, the Barry White thing is very, we do that for me, the, you know.
Sure, you're right, baby.
You know, you do a character with a McDonald girl.
They yes, kind of... you. I heard you doing some McDonald's in the beginning there. It's very funny.
Sure, you're right.
Sure, you're right.
What is the McDonald girl?
Well, she's somebody that I do, that I started doing in New York, that's kind of a combination of a person who works at the post office when it's really crowded and hates your guts. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't want to talk about it. I'll just, if someone happens to have an Afro pick around,
Marla, you got an Afro pick. You call it a natural comb. Oh, thank you.
A natural comb. This is a little bit of the character. This. Mm-hmm. Do you want the regular chicken McNuggets or the family size or the large? I'm sorry, but I have to stand here and do the overring because you ordered a fish sandwich and we're out of fish sandwiches. And then I got to void out your other order, and then I got to push the button that has a picture of the fish sandwich on it. Et cetera.
Sure, you're right. We'll be right back with Nancy Giles.
Right now?
We'll read it together.
Okay.
Back to perform their new single, Rome,
the B-52's.
Yeah.